Čeky organizátorom za zaprošanie a Jacky za organizácii tejto spanilej konferencie. And that's about my Polish, ladies and gentlemen. I've tried hard, even though I'm from Czech Republic, so I'm a Pepik, so we should understand each other. My name is Matěj Miška, and I'll be talking about the creative licensing, whether the collective management societies and the Creative Commons are enemies or not. So let me brief introduce you into the topic of collective management. If you don't understand it, never mind. Please feel free to grab me after the session. We will discuss it through. In three sentences, the raison d'être, why there are even collective management societies, is to create a pool of money and to care about that the monies are distributed to the artists. We basically acknowledge three levels of the relationship between the author and between the creative, the collective management society. The one is statutory, which means that everybody's represented by the society on the basis of law, and you cannot waive it in any way. This includes, for example, the private copying levies. The extended collective management is a very peculiar thing that means that the collective management society is granting licenses to the users, and not only for the ones that are represented, but also for the ones that are not represented. This is like this blanket licensing. And this means that you, if you are an author, can actually opt out of this regime. And the last one is the voluntary one, when you actually assign all of these rights exclusively to the collective management society. There is a slight problem with this, that the represented right holders are not entitled, because of the contract with the management society, because with the collective management society, to grant a license, and not even a Creative Commons license, and not even a non-commercial Creative Commons license. There were some pilots already, pilot projects in the European Union that will try to bridge this gap between the commercial exploitation and the propagation of the works on a non-commercial basis. And it showed that there is some hope. And even though that there are still some barriers, and these pilots were, to say, to a mid-level only successful, pursuant to the new directive that's coming upon us, the Directive 2014/26 on collective management of copyrights, the collective societies and the members of the collective societies, that means the authors that are in the third regime, in the voluntary regime, will be entitled to grant licenses for non-commercial uses of any rights categories of rights and types of works and other subject matter. This is what's coming upon us. And there are two problems with this article. The first one is, of course, the definition of the non-commercial. That's a huge topic that's haunting the Creative Commons licenses since its inception. The definition in the licenses themselves, it's now in the first article, letter K, in the version 4.0, is quite vague, as you can see. It's like opaque and not that clear. As you can see, it's not primarily intended for or directed towards commercial advantage or monetary compensation. What does this actually mean? That's a problem. We don't know what does this actually mean. And during the pilots that were held in Sweden, in Netherlands, France, there were quite a lot of misinterpretation and extensive interpretation of this specific feature, of the non-commercial feature. The collective management societies are not that willing to go for such a vague definition of non-commercial, because the non-commercial licensing that is granted to the authors is actually undermining the basic idea of collective management societies. However, Creative Commons licenses or Creative Commons organization wasn't that willing also to give a clear and cut and really nice definition what does it actually mean, the non-commercial. However, a month ago, an interpreting guide was published that actually stated that the non-commercial is not based upon the type of the user. The user is not therefore decisive. This was, however, the problem with the societies, with the collective societies, that in the pilots said that of course this does matter. An example is, for example, you have a for-profit company, a standard, large, multi-billion dollar company, whatever, and this company, pursuant to the interpretation or the definition in the non-commercial, in the standard Creative Commons license, could actually also make use of non-commercially licensed work if it's pursuant to the purpose of the use, not commercial. A traditional example is a bigger company can make use of, for example, Flickr licensed photos, even though if they are under non-commercial. If it's used, for example, as a gift, a birthday gift for one of the employee. However, if it's targeted as a marketed action or marketing action towards potential customers, then it's considered as a commercial use, and the non-commercial would be fulfilled, therefore the company could not use it. In the pilots, however, they made a nice and clear cut, and they said any undertaking that's targeted towards profit cannot use any non-commercial works. This must be, however, also, this is only, to say, theoretical interpretations. Let's have a look how the courts have interpreted it. And in a German case, where there was a non-commercially licensed photograph used on the web pages in an article that paradoxically deals with the collective management of rights, even by a public broadcaster. It was a standard online article by a public broadcaster about copyright. However, the author sued and he said this was clearly a commercial use. And the court said, yes, of course it was, because they have this nice Zweckübertragungslehre, which means that the rights that are unclear whether they have been or have not been transferred remain by the author. The definition of non-commercial is not clear. Therefore, this means only rein private Nutzung, and that is an exception of copyright. The second problem is, we were talking about this, that as you have seen from the definition, it means that only certain type of rights, categories and types of works or other subject matter could be non-commercially licensed. I don't want to get too lawyery because it's boring being a lawyer. However, this means, if you read it, this does not mean that you can actually license only one specific word under non-commercial license. This means that you can either waive, even though if you are not waiving, the whole repertoire, or you can go for non-commercial for the certain type of rights, which means, for example, putting it online. This means you go to the collective management society, say, okay, I have these works, I want them to bring me some money from a public performance in radios, on TVs. However, I would like to put them online under the non-commercial license. Another problem is, that was also in the CC interpretation, is that any other explanation or any other bindings agreement that go over the Creative Commons licenses itself are not actually binding as such, and then the license cannot be considered a Creative Commons license. This means if you are in a project where you are using a Creative Commons license with some additional terms, it cannot be called a Creative Commons license. And these are the problems we are facing now, whether the Creative Commons and collective management societies are an improbable match or no. I would go rather for know that they are a good match, that you can actually on the one hand make money by, taking care of your rights by the collective management society. It will take care of you about the commercial exploitation. On the other hand, you should be able to promote your work online, non-commercially for your fans. And the problem is, we have now, this is not a problem, it's a huge opportunity. We are now in the period of transposition because the directive has been published. However, we have up until the 10th of April to transpose it into the national laws. And that's only the first step. The second step is that you can then have to transpose it from the law to practice. Therefore, this is a unique opportunity not to let the artist hang in there and just get active, to let your voices be heard. If you are an artist, go talk to the respective right holders. If you are a legislator or an activist, let's be active and let's tell them, okay, I just want to make it work like this. I want to have my non-commercial license. I want to have my commercial exploitation by the Creative Commons, by the Collective Management Society. It's, in the end, it's all about the respect of the will of the author. And I thank you bardzo for your attention. And I wish you good luck in turning the cooperation from no to on. Thank you.